Hi, I'm here with the brothers Cottage Carder, and I have some dyed wool and some alpaca, and I'm gonna put this on and then we'll start up the machine and show you how light we need to run this. So this is the control box with the dial for the speed of the Cottage Carder, and this is the on and off switch. And what's really nice about this box is I can move it wherever I need to, and if I need to, I can take it and position it on the other side. So if I'm a lefty or a righty, and this knob, I'm running about 25, and I'll get this laid onto the conveyor belt, and then we'll see how it's running, whether I need to adjust it or not. Watch it as it goes through the in feed and starts moving on the machine. I think I might be able to turn this up a bit. Okay, now that it has come through and I can gather it, feed it through the diz. What I like to do is feed the wire through the false twist. Put it through that front pinch roller. Run it through the back. And then we'll get a hold of it and see how it will run. there's a roving fed through the fox twist onto the roving. To show you how easy it is to go from a loose roving to a bump, we just tear that off. I'm going to go ahead and break this roving and we're going to drop it into a batt. Running that wool, colored wool and alpaca, and we're running into a batt. And now that the intake belt has fed in the last of the product, I'm going to go ahead and turn it up, walk around to the back, and remove the batt. Around. So I have a bat, the roving, and a bump, all from the brothers Cottage Carder.